So you obviously have to have certain restrictions, both legal and commercial and various other considerations. But when on the web you're telling is to be aware of what is going to see. So I think nothing will be lost in translation in terms of how effectively I can. So I know so much about the or certain image, it's like a part and thing that you can form from something you don't feel it as long as it is coming in context. But trying to hide it or trying to water it down, I think it is doing injustice to the aspect of what it is supposed to be.
Right.
But see, for example, first time one saw an image, it was in Bandit Queen.
Right.
We shared a couple of years, 24 years back. But you know it is coming in a context. It's not meant for a certain reason. But first time you heard explosions in Syria, which came in 1999 or 1998. Even there, they felt it in context. So I think if you've seen it, you know that not a single shot is being did for effect. And you know that they're all a part of a certain world, and that the language and images are things that are an interesting part of the world. That is what my role is.
So but talking about imagery, I think this is the first time perhaps you have pushed the envelope as far as web series goes. Female nudity is not something that we often see in, even in Indian web series. So how did you tackle that subject, and how much of a preparation did it take from the actress's end?
I mean, I would say that when I met actors or actresses, the kind of certain things which are required, when I told them my intention, and I told them what we have 10 people watch in Bangalore, for example, I'm saying, that happens all the time in the digital world. So when I explain this, even the actors who were involved, they were convinced with my sincerity and my logic, and they trusted me with how I do it. Yeah.
As a filmmaker, like an
artist,
the world was rampant in the industry up in the industry. So what was your experience like? And many of your films are also underworld.
Yeah. See, there are two points. One is, I don't think underworld is relevant today as much as in the... I think it pretty much lost its hype. In 2005, I think, that's around 10 years back, 20 years back. But the point is, when you're telling a story, I don't think it's about whether it is happening now or happening. Like in the 1920s is when the mafia started in America, just at the prohibition time. And pretty much by 1950s it got over. And Godfather was made in the early 70s, 1973. So I think any time you see a story, it is eventually the characters and the situation. Well, it's a genre. Mafia is a crime drama. We all understand, like even Satya, when people said, how does Rami know so? He really knows them, he portrayed them realistically. But who did anyone meet a gangster? How do they know it is real? They're connecting to the emotions which seem real, which is the reason it looks real. The pretty much same thing stands for it. Like in the voiceover, it explains. Why was there an escalated criminal activity happening between 1995 and 2005? Because after the breakup of the B company, a lot of other gangs were trying to fight. You can understand that.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a company breaks up, all the competitors will try to corner the market. Exactly the same thing which will happen even in the underworld. So that will create situations, that will create characters, that will create interrelationships which you normally never see otherwise all the time.
So is the nexus between, I mean, the way we see between Bollywood and underworld today still as strong as it was perhaps a decade ago?
Not necessarily. To start with, first of all, I think it's a misconception. People think that there's a nexus between the underworld and Bollywood. See, there are two reasons. Underworld never put money, which is a misconception. Even underworld also has to put money. Why is it underworld?
It's the purpose, you know.
Most of the time, either they use it for publicity, you know, because and they used to get a high to scare who we think are stars and big filmmakers, you know. And the third thing is they used to help friends by making a phone call, things like that. But pretty much the underworld at that time was in a mood of being in the news. They were just very publicity crazy at that time, you know, apart from other reasons what I mentioned. But when the CIU was created, the Encounter Corps, in 1998 to 1999, pretty much by 2004, they killed most of the gangsters. So that created a huge, they also lost a lot in terms of the power and everything. So that pretty much signaled, like I said, the end of it. And disbanding of the Encounter Squad in 2005 more or less is a signal that the underworld as a force has been completely reduced.
Sir, will we get to see the series on YouTube?
Yeah, of course.
But
the point is, whether it's on YouTube or Google, it eventually made for the digital market.
Look, the reason why I'm asking that is because YouTube has a no nudity clause. Unless, of course.
Then it might come in age restriction, depending upon.
No, even in age restriction, it is allowed only if it is for educational or scientific purposes. I think so. Okay.
But sir, because you have majorly made crime dramas and gangster stories, so have you ever been at the receiving end because the subject matter that you're dealing with involves a lot of risk? So has that ever happened to you?
But if I'm still alive, then I was not in the receiving end.
No, but in a way, perhaps that you were ever threatened by
any of the put.
Because the subject is kind of.
Let's do this serious. I said to start with, first of all, why would the underworld have any problem if anyone underworld is a kind of an illegal business organization, for the want of a better world. And they're not concerned about it. They're not like terrorists who are selling an ideology. They're not trying to sell a certain thought in the way they think a filmmaker is trying to counter them. Mm-hmm. No? So pretty much I think they would either ignore or they'd be thinking that there might have been something wrongly or wrongly portrayed. Otherwise, technically speaking, there are no reason to be. It's very much like if I make a film on a businessman won't be upset with me.
Sir, why have you chosen to cast me?